Where is Paul Seglia? All new tonight, U.S. Marshals tell 7 Eyewitness News they're working good leads in the nationwide manhunt for the man who escaped from his Wellsville home. Investigators say Seglia sliced off his ankle monitoring bracelet and took off sometime Monday. But the man who made national headlines for lying about having an ownership stake in Facebook may not be alone. 7 Eyewitness News reporter Kendra Eaglin following this developing story tonight.
Yeah, Joanna, it's been 8 days since anyone has heard from Paul Seglia's wife, and tonight we are learning that both of their cars are still in the driveway of their Wellsville home, but still there is no sign of the couple or their 2 children. Paul Seglia, his 36-year-old wife Iesa, and their 2 sons, 10-year-old Lehman and 11-year-old Josephine, are nowhere to be found. Prosecutors say Seglia cut off his electronic monitoring bracelet and created a makeshift contraption so that authorities would still think he was inside of his Wellsville home. The couple's family believes Paul Seglia fled to avoid facing an upcoming trial in May, where he's charged with committing fraud in a lawsuit that he filed against the owner of Facebook. Seglia claimed to own half of the social media company. I talked to Iesa's sister in California, who tells me their entire family is worried sick.
I know my sister, and I know that she wanted to be near her family, and I know she would not take off and not tell us where she was going.
We went out to the house to try to locate him, mm-hmm. Got into his residence in Wellsville, found that the bracelet was actually at his residence, so he did remove it. There was some vehicles at the residence. Some personal belongings were still there. However, the family was not.
Investigators say the last confirmed contact with Iesa was 8 days ago when she communicated with a friend of hers online. Friends and family filed a missing persons report on Tuesday. The family tells me that the boys were homeschooled, so they weren't missing from classes. Now, back in 2009, the couple was charged with defrauding customers in a wood pellet business that they own. Coming up at 6, we'll hear more from my interview with Iesa's sister and hear what she describes as Paul Seglia's controlling behavior. Reporting live, Kendra Eaglin, 7 Eyewitness News.